Many times people ask questions that currently I'm having COVID-19 infection, should I take the vaccine? Or some people already have been infected with COVID-19. They ask whether they do need a vaccine or not, because the belief is that the natural infection must have given them lifelong immunity and they won't need the vaccine. Those who are currently having COVID-19 infection, of course, they must not take the vaccine, because right now the infection is active in the body. Once they recover, 2 weeks after the recovery, they can start taking the vaccine, right? Do they need to take the vaccine? Yes, definitely they need to take the vaccine. You have heard that reinfection can occur even after getting the infection. So it's not a must that you are completely protected. So to prevent any such eventuality, those who got infected with COVID-19 should definitely take the complete course of the vaccine. There are many people with several medical conditions and they are in dilemma whether they should take the vaccine, whether it is safe for them to take the vaccine. So conditions like diabetes, blood pressure, kidney disorders or cardiac diseases, what about them? So these kind of people have been tested in clinical trials and the vaccine has been found very safe and effective. So there is nothing to worry. They should take the vaccine. In fact, they need the vaccine the most because they are highly susceptible to getting the severe disease. So this category is not a problem. What about the people who are, let's say, like immunocompromised, their immune system is weak? Let's say somebody has got a kidney transplant and he's taking some immunosuppressive therapies. So these are the people with immunocompromised conditions. They have not been tested to a full extent in clinical trials. We do not have adequate data on them. So their doctor should take a call based on the benefit risk analysis, because these are the people we need to remember who are highly vulnerable to get a severe disease. What about pregnant women? What about the women who are breastfeeding their children? Again, the same situation. We do not have adequate data to say directly that yes, you can go ahead and take it. The doctor should take a call on the basis of benefit risk analysis. Then there are other kind of people who are on some kind of blood thinning medications, like some of them can be on aspirin to give them protection from heart attacks or strokes. There are some people who are on anticoagulant drugs, or there are some people who are having bleeding disorders. So the reason behind this is that this vaccine is given by intramuscular route into your muscle. So if these people get a vaccine in the injection in the muscle, and this holds true for any vaccine, for any injection, then there are high chances of bleeding at the injection site or bruising. That's all. There are no other side effects that are expected with this. So these people should be careful, and the doctor should be careful while taking the vaccine. Those on aspirin can definitely take the vaccine. Even those who are on anticoagulants or bleeding disorders, they can take the vaccine. Just be cautious while getting the injection.